It's AumSum time.
Hi guys, can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
Is sitting bad for you? Today's lifestyle makes many of us sit much more than we move around. Hence, researchers have stated that sitting has become the new smoking. Now, sitting for a brief time is not harmful. But looking at the number of bones, joints, and muscles in our body, we can say that our bodies are built to move. In addition to this, our skin is elastic, which means it stretches and bends according to our movements. This indicates that as our body requires movement, our skin has evolved to become elastic. Moreover, standing or moving around does not affect our blood circulation and transmission of nerve impulses. However, sitting in a specific posture for extended periods can compress blood vessels and nerves in various body parts, thus affecting the blood circulation and causing numbness. Hence, the formation of our body indicates that it is built to stand against gravity and move around more often. So, we should avoid sitting for too long. What is a tsunami?
I don't know!
Tsunami is a series of giant waves. In Japanese, tsunami means harbor wave.
And in Chinese?
Oh, just listen. A wave is created when energy passes through water. Moving air or wind provides energy to water, forming regular waves. While on the ocean floor, when a tectonic plate suddenly slides beneath the other, the resulting earthquake releases a tremendous amount of energy. This energy spreads outward from the point of earthquake, triggering waves that can form tsunami. Initially, these waves are small in size, but they travel at great speeds. However, when the waves approach the shore, the rising seabed obstructs the energy of waves. This slows down the speed of waves, but the energy flux must remain constant, leading to an increase in the height of waves, thus resulting in tsunami. Is gluten bad for you?
Dude! Gluten is bad for everybody.
As usual, you are wrong. Gluten is a combination of proteins found in grains like wheat, barley, and rye. Gluten makes dough sticky and gives pasta its chewiness. Now, gluten is not usually harmful, but people having a digestive disorder called celiac disease should not consume gluten.
But why?
When people having celiac disease eat gluten, it triggers an autoimmune response. In this response, the immune cells attack our own body tissues, damaging the villi present in the small intestine, thus causing inflammation, diarrhea, fatigue, etc. In addition to this, damaged villi will not be able to absorb the required nutrients, thus causing weight loss, iron deficiency, etc. Thus, people suffering from celiac disease, as well as those having gluten-related allergies, should preferably have a gluten-free diet.
Hello.
Why does our voice sound different when recorded?
Our inner ear detects sound vibrations, informing our brain about the voice or sound, and thus helping us hear. But did you know that when we speak, we hear our own voice in two different ways?
What? In two different ways?
Indeed. The first way is through our outer ear. Our voice travels to the outer ear, creating vibrations in the eardrum. These vibrations eventually reach the inner ear. While the second way is through our flesh and skull bones. However, they are better at transmitting deeper, lower frequency sounds as compared to shriller, higher frequency sounds. As a result, the combination of sounds obtained from the two ways makes our voice appear deeper. Now, when we hear our recorded voice, we only hear the voice which has traveled through our outer ear. Hence, our voice sounds different when recorded. Topic: gravitational force. why do you weigh less on the moon? Hey, what are you doing? It is not possible. You cannot fly on Earth. Please listen. Look, I had warned you. Now, why don't you try the same activity on the moon? There, you will weigh much less, and thus, you can fly short distances. See? I was correct. Do you know why you weighed less on the moon? To understand this, we need to first learn about weight. No, not those weights. Weight is the force with which an object is pulled towards the center of the Earth or any other celestial body. This force is called the gravitational force. Greater the gravitational force exerted by the celestial body, more will be the weight of an object present on it. So, does this mean that the moon exerts less gravitational force than the Earth? Bingo. You are right. But do you know why? This is because gravitational force is directly proportional to the mass of an object. Greater the mass, greater will be the gravitational force exerted by it, and thus, more will be our weight. As the moon has lesser mass than the Earth, it has a weaker gravitational pull, and hence, we weigh less on the moon.